that's, you know.
Only Marvel had a hold of that franchise these days.
Yeah. If only the Supreme Court had its head off, screwed on right back in 2000, the whole history of the world would be different. You know, it's like, we can wish for blue in the face, or you can be like me and rewrite history. But then it falls under fiction. And even when you rewrite history and do X-Men Forever, if it doesn't sell, it doesn't, you know, what's the point? So, you know, you just, the basic response to all of this is you have to take a deep breath, suck up, move on, and try and fix things next time. There's no right or wrong in this, really. This is the way the world works, and you either have to invent a better world or do your best to position yourself in the world as it exists, that you can affect changes to what you're doing and where you're going within the framework. And you know, the frustrating news is, I didn't get my 10 seconds of adulation. Okay. On the other hand, hey, Channing Tatum. You thought, what will that lead to? You know, it's, you just keep playing. The point is, as long as the game's going, it still goes on. As long as you're in the play, you have a shot. And the game's still going on, and I'm still in play, and I'm taking every shot I get my hands on, because it's cool. Yeah.
What would you tell to aspiring writers and everything that want to eventually do stuff like what you've done with X-Men and some of the properties that you have? What would you say to them that are coming up in the art world and in the writing world? What tips would you give them to aspire to be something like what you've gotten?
Lovely. You want to look at how you should view this paradigm? You got me, you got JK. And I'm not being facetious. I spent 20 years writing the X-Men. It was a lot of fun. I built these characters, I built the canon. I laid the foundation for everything that came afterwards. It has made Avi Roth very rich. It has made Disney very rich. I'm okay, but I'm not very rich. J.K. Rowling wrote her novel, sold her novel, sold the second novel, the third novel, the fourth novel, the fifth novel, sold the movie rights, did this. She has all the cool stuff that the X-Men has. Oh, except she owns it, which makes all the difference. So that's the first question you have to address if you're talking about being creative and wanting to make it creative. Do you want to do your stuff, or do you want to do someone else's stuff? If you do someone else's stuff, you can still do brilliant work. You can be a Frank Miller. You can do Dark Knight. You can do Wolverine. 300, though, that was Frank, doing Frank. But the Dark Knight is DC. Wolverine is Marvel. Or you can take the risk of hoping that your own creative work, the stuff that's yours, makes the difference, is successful. In which case, it all comes down to you. So that really is the first question that every creator has to address and figure out for themselves. How you want to play this and where you want to go. If only the movie had been. So, you know, Stan deserves everything he's got and more. And his debt, the debt that we owe him as fans is almost impossible to repay. And he'll still do autographs, which is cool. When you're 60, it's not bad. You know, you know, but Stan, God bless him. And, you know, keep on fighting. The world, at least from my eye, will be sadder. Okay, just a couple more questions, because otherwise I would get rich by now with people waiting for me. Yeah.
Throughout your career writing for the X-Men, what was your favorite story arc that you wrote?
The one I haven't written yet. In terms of Uncanny, 94 through 279 inclusive. You know, I come from the days of the Comics Code Authority, and instead of an angel, a tweety angel coming up and saying, "Isn't that having so wonderful?" Logan comes up and gives him a beer. And they sit on the edge of creation and just slug back some good water and talk about what guys talk about. And if you believe that, you haven't been paying attention to Wolverine for the last 30 years. So hopefully it'll be a fun scene. Or it could just fall flat on its face, but it visually looks great. We'll see. And the second issue's out, the third issue's on my table. And come take a look. Thank you very much for being so.
Toxic Pop has a new Facebook page. Like it to see pictures and keep informed about our upcoming events and videos. A link is in the description. Go to www.facebook.com/toxicpop1.